Hey guys. Today we are playing a new game called Accident. It is available on early access on Steam. Basically, it's a game set in 2036 where you, a reporter for a magazine company called Automag about cars, basically goes back in time using a virtual reality headset to examine and play through scenarios where there were car crashes in the shoes of the people who were on scene. Not the people that got hurt, but the first citizens on scene. And this is like when, you know, first responders can't get there that quick sort of stuff. So basically, you save lives, you try to examine what happened, you piece together all the evidence, and decide what happened. It's actually very interesting. It's time limited, of course, though, because people can die. You have to resuscitate some folk. You have to peel cars apart, basically, and try to save them. It's very interesting, all while trying to keep yourself from dying. Like, if you are on a highway scenario, you might get hit by a car, and you'll die. You'll have to restart. You know, you catch on fire, you die, you restart. First aid kit's not working, all that stuff, really. It's amazing. This is a scenario called Street Race, set in 2004 in Tennessee, United States of America. It's like 1:42 in the morning, and you're playing some guy named, like, Wilfred something. But basically, yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and start with this, and, yeah, check it out on Steam, please. It's a pretty neat game. Oh, what's that? Take off our headset and run! Run! Sorry about the minimal lag. I actually finally got it figured out, so the quality is a little bit better, and I'll continue to work on that. Anyways. Oh, man. So I'm thinking this guy was pushing the shopping cart, which he was probably using as a home because he's homeless, across there. Alright, so we should probably call the authorities here. Pull out the phone. I don't know. We're out of battery. We need, like, a phone booth. There you go. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and call emergency services. Okay, so we're not gonna hang up. We have to secure everything, so we called emergency services. We have to turn off the ignition in the cars and mark the accident locations, probably using road flares because it's night. So turn off the ignition in this car. Does he have road flares in his car? No, he doesn't. Okay. He looks like he's passed out. It's not good. That door is jammed. This one's not. Okay. Let's turn off of his ignition. There's a street racer. That's what this guy is. Ooh, jeez. Okay, trunk button unlock. I don't know if we need- Oh wait, he probably has road flares in the back of his car. Yeah, it's locked. He's probably got the road flares, so let's get in there. I played through this scenario before, so it's just warning. I kinda know everything to do with this, but I know that. Okay, let's open the trunk. Alright, first aid kit, you always want to pick that up, and the flares. Sweet, so we gotta put one, like, right over here on every street. You have to put one, just to mark where the accident is so that people can be wary. Like, over in, Europe and stuff, you're actually required to carry road flares, high visibility jackets, triangles and stuff, all sorts of stuff like that. Okay, so we're going to assess the situation now. How's this guy doing? Oh, geez, there's two of them in here. I didn't realize that. Okay, oh, you gotta take the seatbelt off and check for breathing here. He's breathing. That's good. Okay. Let's go to her. Is she okay? I really hope she's okay. Really, they're all alright. Okay, gotta unbuckle her seatbelt. Open the airway. She's breathing too. She's breathing. Alright, good. Close the door. It might get cold tonight. So I don't want them to get all cold and stuff on top of almost dying. Alright, hey man! Oh, we forgot the guy that got hit. The crosswalk dude. Okay, Freddy Weaver is this guy's name. I'm all for, like, you know, racing cars safely, but, like, street racing, dude, come on. Alright, so we got the wounds and bruises. He is not breathing. We have to do CPR on them. And then we gotta go check him first, and then we have to figure out our exact location. I don't have a car, and none of those cars have a GPS, so... Excuse me, sir. He's got multiple wounds. Probably got one. There's another wound. So he is breathing, which is surprising for the amount of blood he lost. Okay, so street signs. That's how we gotta do this. Street signs. We are in the corner of South and 8th Avenue. South and 8th Avenue South. I'm gonna pass the information over to the dispatcher. Okay. We gotta pull him out and do CPR on him until the ambulance arrives. Okay. We gotta get in. No, we don't have to get in. We actually have to get back out. No, jeez. I'm an idiot. Alright, he is slowly dying though, and he is in dire need of someone to actually save him. That's good. Okay, first aid. Wearing shorts, really, to race a car? I wouldn't expect that. Okay, we have to open his airway. Now we have our gloves on, put the CPR mask onto him. First, we do chest compressions. 30 of them, okay? 2. This is actually more difficult than you'd think, because if you don't do this, like, perfect the next amount of times, you're gonna end up killing the guy. And that wouldn't be very good. Okay, now we have to do artificial ventilation. Okay, there's 2. He's not breathing still, so we have to continue doing CPR until the meat wagon gets here. Alright, there it is. That is not a United States siren. That's like a EU siren. That's European, man. That's European. Europe in your business. Okay, discover the cause. Alright, so first things first, this is the impact point. Alright, so I'm beginning to see what happened here. So we got some skid marks here. So, first off, alright, so those skid marks are from his car. He slammed on them right about here. Oh, he hit the guy in the crosswalk, slammed on the brakes, and stopped here, and then the side impact, because this car was already in. Okay, yeah, alright, I'm beginning to see. That's what my assumption is. So we gotta, I need to find, sports car, obviously. Stops in the middle of the intersection after hitting that guy. What's this? The pamphlet. Okay, so now we have all 4 clues, we just have to order them correctly. So, Freddy Weaver participates in an illegal street race. William Maddox is hit by Freddy's sports car. The sports car stops in the intersection, and the little blue thing hits it. Okay. Alright. Oh, he's dead. In addition to several injuries, the crash broke William's left leg. As a result of his poor overall health, William immediately slipped into a coma. His health was so poor that he never recovered from it and died in the hospital 4 months later. That sucks. Freddy Weaver, your immediate assistance saved Freddy's life. The paramedics were able to revive him on the way to the hospital, where he was charged with causing serious injury by reckless driving, which eventually resulted in a 10-year prison sentence. Jeez. That's long. Jason didn't suffer any serious injuries from the accident and was quickly released from the hospital. He soon became interested in Freddy Weaver's case, and some believe his testimony was the main reason for Freddy's unusually high sentence, although no one was able to find any solid evidence. And Bethany Hampton, just like her husband, the accident did not cause Bethany any major injuries. Just 2 weeks later, she was able to return to work as the mayor's assistant. Alright, so that was a complete scenario. That only took about, 10 minutes? Yeah, it was a pretty short one. So we'll do one more of them. I don't see why not. I would do a modern one, but I also kind of want to do the old one, the 70s one. I don't know yet. The 70s one's my second favorite, and it's a pretty good one, and it's in the U.S., so that's kind of cool. We'll do that one. Why not? It's actually very, very interesting. Set in the 70s, you know? When they're set in the 70s, they're pretty cool. Alright, that was the sound of him taking off his VR headset. Him, her, them taking off their VR headset. Alright, so we got Highway Disaster now. Not that one. That's the one. New Mexico, USA, August 15th, 1972, 11:47, just about noon. You are Jason B. Herrera, and apparently you are basically the first responder on scene. It's called Desert Encounter. That's a prison bus. You all will see what happens. It's pretty cool. This one's good. Okay, here we go. Ta-da! Jeez, that was like an old Pontiac GTO Judge. That sucks. That was a nice car. That was a really nice car, actually. What I would give for a GTO Judge. Actually, no. I would love a Mercury Cougar Eliminator with the 428 Super Cobra Jet. That would be awesome. They're rare, but they are awesome. Alright, listen to emergency dispatch and do what they say. They have a lot more experience with accidents than you. Okay, you guys will see what happens here. It's actually a very kind of far-fetched, but then again, you know, it's kind of not. Alright. Should load in any minute now. Alright, finally loaded in. Here we are. Alright, we're driving on the highway in New Mexico in 1972. 1972. Pretty cool. Only have four on the floor. Oh! Here it is, here's the accident. We're gonna pull over. Alright, stop here, yeah, just about. Okay. That's not very good. Alright, so we have to call in the emergency. We gotta figure out how to, though. Let's check in our glove box, the map. Maybe see. Okay, so. Okay then. So we gotta find my exact location. Probably like mile markers and stuff. Probably best, yes. Where's the car? What are we driving anyways? Ooh, yeah, that's good. That's like a little Nova. That is pretty cool. Alright. I wonder if these are, like, based off of, like, real things. Alright. Oh, jeez. Alright. So, this isn't very good. Broken sign, yeah. There's gotta be a gas station along here. Oh, no. Oh, no. They broke out. That's not very good at all. Okay, so we gotta hurry along that gas station at some point. Hop back in the Nova, and right off into the sunset. Looks like one person is already dead. If you look in the bottom left, the health bars of people, so one person's already passed away, sadly. Probably the cop, I really... it might be the car. Yeah, it's the guy in the car, I think. Oh, I didn't want to get out of the water. Let's drive. Four on the floor, baby. Okay. Alright, let's get out. So we are at the gas station. Alright, gotta be a phone or something here. Okay, I don't know. Is there a phone? Is there, like, anything? Can I get off the porch here? Thank you. Here we are. There's the phone. Thank you for all the information. The ambulance and police are preparing to leave as we speak. Now listen to me carefully. I won't be able to guide you, so you'll need to pay attention now. I'd like to ask you to return to the scene of an accident and help as much as you can. First, the convicts may still be around, so for your safety, please start by locking away all the guns, if there are any. Also, the sheriff asks that you do so with some sort of cloth so you don't leave your own fingerprints. After that, you'll need to turn off the ignition in all the cars, check all the victims, and decide who you're going to help. Choose a person whose life is most threatened. Good luck. Well, that was bleak. You couldn't have said, like, do this, do that. Okay, we need to find the first aid kit. It's not gonna be back there. I know that for a fact. Nothing there. What about back in here? Wait. Oh, there it is. First aid kit. 70s first aid kit. Cool. Alright. Oh, yeah. Pretty cool. Kinda wanna look around here and stay here for a while. Do we have to go save people? Trunk. We can't open the trunk. Trunk's locked. It should be at least. I don't know. Either way, we need to go quickly now. Do I have a cloth? Oh yeah, there we are. Handkerchief. We'll get that when we get there. Alright, let's go. Alright. Grab our handkerchief. We start with the guns, because I don't want to get shot here. That would suck. First off, we gotta put all in the trunk. I'm gonna grab the keys so we can unlock the trunk, or lock the trunk rather. Can't yet. Okay, that's alright. Well, let's go find them. First off, I'm actually gonna try to turn off the ignition in the judge and the bus before we do anything else, because I don't want them catching fire. That would really suck. Alright, here we are. The revolver. Alright, like a little Colt something or other. 38 special. Yeah, alright. So that's one gun. Ha ha ha. Alright, this police officer. There's a second one. We'll get that on the way out. We gotta stop the engine in this first. Oh no, was he shot? I think he was shot. Jeez, okay. We really gotta hurry up here. So the engine's off in all the vehicles. We gotta pick up this gun and we gotta hurry up. Is there like a rifle or something, or is it just like revolvers? It's two revolvers. It's like it's police standard issue revolver there. Jeez. That's quite an indent that made. I'm getting kind of confused what happened. Of course, I already know. I'm just gonna act like I don't, you know, for the sake of the video. Okay. Oh no. Prisoner? Is he okay? I don't know. I don't really care. He's a prisoner. Well, I do, but I don't at the same time, you know. Depending on what he did, I mean, if he just, like, you know, I don't know, got caught in the wrong place at the wrong time doing the suspicious thing, then, yeah, you know, I sympathize with him, but who knows. Jeez, okay, I cannot find that third gun. I mean, wait, it might be in the car. I think it might be in the car. Yep, there it is. I didn't think about that. So it's in the car, so that has something to do with it. Go put this in the back of that Nova. That's a nice car. That little thing. We need to grab the keys out of the ignition so that we can lock that trunk. I know a lot about classic cars. I actually worked on them in auto shop a long time ago. Alright, lock that trunk. Alright. What's this? Driver's door? Okay, that's interesting, but alright, so we gotta check all of our victims. Let's check this guy first. Ooh, that's a lot of blood, and it's back all the way there. Yeah, bullet wound. That's what I thought. He's dead. Yeah, I just noticed that, you know. I also studied forensics for a while. You kinda get a natural feel for this stuff. Alright, is this guy okay? Hey. Shake him by the shoulder. Open his airway, let's see if he's breathing. Oh, he got shot in the shoulder here, alright. And then he is not breathing, I don't think. Okay, that's not very good. We need to get out of the bus, run back to this guy. Oh, he got shot, alright. Can you hear me, buddy? Let's hear you breathe, alright. Alright, he's breathing. That's good. Oh, wait, he did get shot in the stomach. Ah, that's a gut shot. He might be alright, though. If it's lower, it's just intestines. Or maybe not even intestines. He could be just fine. Alright, close that door. Then we gotta get the guy in the back. Is he okay? Alright, so it looks like he has one wound. Oh, yeah, it's like a wound probably from wreck or gunshot. He's breathing. Good. Alright. So now we gotta help the guy that needs help the most, that we can actually still kinda help. And that would be our bus driver. He really needs help right now. Like, right now. He needs it yesterday. Come on now, buddy. We're gonna save you. And you're not gonna die on us. Because that would suck. That's like 70s. They'd get that awesome. Okay. Open up his airway. Okay. One. Come on. Gotta save him here. Because if we don't, he's gonna die. And that would suck. Okay, let's do breathing part. No mask. It's old school. Alright. Okay. Check for breathing. Damn it. Come on. Alright, we gotta keep going. That is not what they sounded like back then. Alright, yeah. They were more like, of course, in the 40s, ambulance is like, yes, it's stupid. Okay, so there's no clues in here as to what happened, but, judging from the damage, alright, so judging from the damage, this is a top-heavy vehicle, I'm assuming, because we got some bullet holes, or bolt holes in the wheels there. The door got ripped open really hard, obviously. So I'm gonna keep on going over here. Alright, so this thing hit that thing right about there. There's an impact point. Spent casings, alright, so yeah, spent casings from the revolvers probably. Debris. The bus flips over and tumbles along the road, that's what I thought. So it starts right about back here. So what I'm thinking is, they were driving along in the bus. The guy in the black car that has a gun has another, like, another couple people with him, I guess, maybe. And they're just trucking along here behind that thing. They shoot the rear left tire. The bus starts dragging that way. The bus driver overcorrects. Bus skids out, loses control, flips. And then the rest is history. Hopefully not too much history, you know. Kind of like him to stay alive. But let's just keep on going up this way. We do not know what else there is that we missed here. That's not important. Also not important. So what am I missing? Bus loses control because the robbers shoot the tire of the bus. Hey, look at that. An old Capri, Monte Carlo or something like that. Yeah. Sweet. Anyways, bus flips. This car hits the other thing. Alright, yep. The driver of the little judge here at the GTO gets shot. And of course this is... Okay, we got all six. Alright, so, I'm gonna say first, a bullet... Wait, no. The prison bus is attacked by bandits. A bullet blows the tire. The bus, flips over. Loses control, flips over. The bus driver shoots at the attackers. The bandit is hit in the head, and the black car hits the bus. Oh, we got it. Alright. Elliot Barrett was taken straight to the nearest hospital while being resuscitated the long way. The doctors miraculously managed to save his life, but the collision with the car broke his neck. He was already weakened with the old age. He lost a lot of oxygen, and he was paralyzed for the rest of his life. He died 8 years after the accident and was buried by his wife. Wow. I kind of paraphrased it a bit. That's sad, incredibly. But at least he's alive. Brock Bolton. Despite losing consciousness, Brock's condition was not as severe as it might appear. The bullet managed to avoid any major organs. After a careful operation and a long convalescence, he returned to duty as a police officer. He was immediately awarded a Purple Heart Medal and a commendation. He quickly rose in the ranks and ended his career as a major in charge of a small police station in his hometown. Alright, that's cool. So everybody's kind of alive here. Oliver Grant was killed during the chase with the prison bus. As an orphan and only low-ranking member of his organization, nobody claimed his remains. He was buried in a potter's field at the nearest cemetery. His funeral was attended only by cemetery employees. Well, that's too bad. And Jerry Tanner, after the attack, Jerry Tanner was brought to the prison hospital where his wounds were treated. After that, he served the rest of his sentence in relative peace, and now works as a carpenter in a remote town in Alaska, far from the memories of his criminal past. Well, that's good. I'm glad he turned his act around, so he's not dead. Alright. Interesting. Okay, so we've done a street race and a 1970s prison bus attack that you would have seen out of, like, Fast and Furious. That was actually the third Fast and Furious. Or was it the fourth, technically? The third or the fourth? But still, the one where they hit the prison bus in the beginning. Very interesting, though. And the way that they did this, they did it wonderfully, you know, where it goes with the times. You know, in 2004, you know, phones didn't have great batteries. It's out of battery, because, you know, he was listening to music, probably on, like, an iPod or something. But still, you know, he ran out of battery, had to use a payphone. You know, 70s, got to use a payphone, because, you know, cell phones aren't even a thought yet. Alright, so basically, other than that, there are a ton of cases that you can do, and, you know, it's really worth it, because it's a good pastime, especially in times of the pandemic, and yeah, it's really fun, I gotta say. It's fun, I'm actually pleasantly surprised with it. I thought it was gonna be pretty stupid, but it's pretty good. So I recommend you check it out for yourself. You can get the demo on Steam and check it out for yourself, and then maybe get it. I didn't do that, and that was probably a mistake, but I thought it would be, but no. It was worth the risk. Alright, guys, thank you for watching. Keep clean, keep safe. Don't die on me, please. Alright, and most of all, keep sane. Alright, we all need to just chill out and... You know, we'll get through the times of, we'll get through 2020. Alright. Rock and roll, everybody. This has been Dubred Gaming.